thanks to your overwhelming support, I've amassed 10,000 subscribers. I honestly didn't expect to get to this point ever, but here it is, and just, wow. I'm overwhelmed, seriously. Just thank you so much, everyone, for watching my videos and supporting the channel. So now, as promised, here are some questions and accompanying answers. First question. Would you want to see beta weapons or beta-styled weapons be introduced into the game? Honestly, not really. I'm not a fan of most of the beta weapons, especially Scout's Nail Gun, because if that thing works anything close to the syringe gun that Medic has in the current game, then no thank you. Do you get recognized in-game at all? Actually, it appears like every other game I get recognized by someone, and most of the time it's super cool. Seeing support for my stuff, even outside of my YouTube comments, is crazy. What are your most loved cosmetics or weapon skins from your backpack? Oh boy, I know this is gonna be super expected, but my Disco Beatdown Greased Lightning and Hot Blue Mew Scattergun. Just, I can't believe a kind soul was nice enough to give me these. If you got to tour Valve, what would you do in there? Well, I'd just swing by all the stuff that's going on and check out the TF team, and overall, I'm curious to see their enthusiasm for the game because it seems super nice. How did you first find TF2 and why have you stuck around so long? I explained how I first found TF2 already in my second talking video, and I've stuck around so long because TF2 is something that's super fun that I can always fall back on, plus all the customizable stuff it offers. In your opinion, do you see war paints as a good replacement for skins, both in-game and as part of the overall economy? Honestly, yeah. With weapon skins, you just unbox some random fucking weapon with a random skin, and you might care about it, or you might not, and eh, it sucked. But with war paints, you have more of a choice. Sure, you still get a random skin from the tier list, but at least now you can choose what you want to use the skin with. The only problem now is indecisiveness. Is modding Shitstorm going to be returning? And if so, how often? Honestly, I do want to do more modding Shitstorm stuff. The only problem is that it's a series that focuses on bad cave story mods, and, you know, cave story is sort of obscure, and cave story mods don't come around as frequently as they used to. And on top of that, I feel really bad, like, insulting someone's mod if they put a lot of dedication, passion, work into it, you know? I just feel like an asshole. So if there's a mod where there was obviously no effort, yeah, I'll probably do it. You said in your previous video that you changed from various recording softwares for various reasons. Why did you switch? Honestly, Shadowplay was a pain in the ass to set up every time I wanted to use it because of the lack of support for multiple audio tracks. And of course it has that support now, but since the settings on that program are so lackluster, it just... no. I need control of my audio bit and sample rate, and Shadowplay doesn't have that, so... goodbye. Are you gay? Last time I checked... no. Question. Relationship status?
This must be a heartbreaker to all the comments saying, "You're so gay, cause I'm his girlfriend, so he's taken."
How proud are you of your videos? If I make a video and I'm not proud of it, it's not gonna be public on my channel. So, yes, I'm very proud of my videos. Will you be doing any more explained videos, like, what is SV Pure? Yeah, I'm gonna be doing more explained videos too, of course. I really like making those, and I like helping give the community more knowledge, so it's a win-win. Are you a furry? Actually, no. Everyone thinks I'm a furry because of the, you know, look-alike furry OC blue cat picture, but honestly, I'm not a furry. I have no problem with furries, though. How did you start your TF2 channel? I signed up for YouTube, forgot about it, and then years later posted a RoboCrate unboxing. Then later I built a computer, remembered that I like doing video stuff, and here I am. What games do you plan on playing or talking about in the future? Honestly, I'm not sure. As I mentioned earlier in the video, TF2 is a game that I can come back to a lot and just have a fun time with. However, I do like stuff like Spelunky, but I'm going to be trying to get into more stuff, so stay tuned. What is your favorite TF2 update? Probably Gunmetal, because there was a brief period of time where I just didn't play TF2 for a while because my... well, at the time, processor was shit. But Gunmetal, when that came out, oh my god. It was full of stuff, and I had a friend to play with, so it brought me back from that mini-vacation. I haven't left since. Any tips for a content creator trying to grow like me? My tip is make a video about something that no one else has talked about before. In my case, I made a video about default settings, because, as I stated, nobody had talked about that before, and I didn't expect it to blow up, but it did. Can you do a face reveal at the end of the Q&A? Why not right now? What inspired you to start YouTube? When I was younger, I used to film a lot of videos with my old digital camera that was like 240p, didn't have a built-in microphone, and I guess that never really left. What process do you go through when making videos? If it's a talking video, I think of stuff that happened to me from the previous week or whatever period of time. I sit down to play around to TF2 and I just talk. For scripted videos, I come up with an idea, I write it down in a document, do a voiceover, put the audio all together, then put clips in as I see fit. Do you have any videos that you never released because you thought it was a bad idea? There was one video I was planning on doing a few years ago called MGE Me, and basically I was gonna do MGEs with a bunch of my friends, one after the other, and see how many wins I could get. But the issue was, the commentary just wasn't that entertaining, so although I finished the whole video, I never rendered it. It's lost to time now, unfortunately. How did you get the name Aar? Well, my name's Aaron. Take away the on. Aar. There you go. I'm really uncreative. Can you show us your TF2 loadouts? Well, here you go. Here's my scout. Here's my soldier. Here's my pyro. Here's my demo. Here's my heavy. Here's my engineer. Here's my medic. Here's my sniper. And there's the sneaky man. How many hours do you have in TF2? As of the time of recording, 2,291 hours. Why you chose to be TF2 YouTuber? TF2 is something that I enjoy, and there are so many aspects to it that you can make videos about a lot of things related to it. What is the most expensive hat or skin you bought? Oh gosh, and I'm not sure about hats or skins, but I remember buying a genuine balloonicorn from the community market for 20 bucks. If you had to pick one weapon from TF2, what would it be and how would you change it? I would take the red tape recorder and speed up the destruction rate, but keep the leveling down rate the same. So it harms the building, but it levels it down slower than it hurts the building, and the building can be destroyed before it's leveled down completely. Kinda hard to explain, but that's what I'd do. Do you have any favorite songs? I like a lot of punk rock music, so stuff like Blink-182, The Offspring, Alkaline Trio. So I guess a few of my favorite songs are First Date, The Kids Aren't Alright, Too Dumb to Die, Jesus of Suburbia, Bored to Death, and, you know, other stuff like that. Do you consider joining TFCL or Highlander someday, or do you prefer sticking to casual fun? I've played a total of one Face It match in my life, and a bit of Valve's in-game competitive matchmaking, and I'm not so sure about Highlander, but if I weren't so anxious and terrified, I'd probably try to play Sixes at least a little bit. Alright, so I think that's it for the questions. Thanks for submitting them. I'm sorry if I couldn't get to yours, there were a lot to sift through, and this video is longer than I anticipated it would be already. Again, thank you so much to everyone for allowing me to reach this huge milestone. It might not seem like a lot compared to other YouTube personalities, but this means the world to me. Thanks for watching my videos and supporting me. You've helped a lot to make this experience enjoyable. As always, see you next time.